Helm and Bob Cribbin. Cribbin's took Shuttle Columbia on its first lap surrounding Earth. Homecoming, 2 days later at Edwards Air Force Base. California landing site served as the main landing area for the early shuttle program. These days, as the program heads towards sunset, it's the backup. New assessments of the radiation leakage from a Japanese nuclear plant have prompted officials to raise the severity of the crisis. It's now pegged at the highest level on an international scale, putting it on par with the 1986 Chernobyl disaster. Officials say the radiation that's leaked so far is a tenth of what was emanated at Chernobyl. And Orlando Radio Show running an employment-related challenge against Governor Rick Scott. That's Jason Bailey of the Buckethead Show on our sister station, Rail Radio 104.1. So why should the governor care? Well, the answer to that's because the Bucket Show's trademarked the Let's Get to Work slogan the Scott campaign's been using. If the governor wins the challenge to get more people to work in the next 30 days than the radio show, Bailey says he'll give him the trademark to his slogan. If not, he'll tell him to quit using it. Bailey says either way, the idea is to get jobs for more Floridians. 540 WSLA News Time, now 802. Get these stories and more at 540WSLA.com. Sports is coming up.
From the David Moss, that's right over from Traffic Center. Eastbound I-4 is very slow from John Young Park Ranch. Make your way into Colonial Drive. You are slow and down westbound along I-4 between 434 and 2 Maitland Boulevard. If you're headed from 434 and 2 Colonial Drive, it's about a 16-minute trip. Westbound along the far away and further along from Dean Road into Golden Rock. Continue to stand behind along the freeway and no problems in either direction at 528 this morning. From the Traffic Center, reporting from
Traffic on Air Online, a service of Waterford Lakes Fun Fair.
Great to have you with us here on the 50,000-watt front porch. The Bud Man, Jeff and Mike holding the fort in the control room. Jenna still out for a couple of more days of R&R. She'll be back later on in the week. Guys, you're doing a great job. And boy, we've had some fantastic calls on a host of hot topics from around town to around the world. Here where God and country are honored and old-fashioned American values never go out of style. And I am privileged to hold court on the 50,000-watt front porch and talk to the smartest audience in talk radio. And that is you. I'm so grateful that you're here with us, and in increasing numbers. It's really exciting what's happening with this station and this show. Now, We're getting ready to hear Barack Obama suddenly try and exercise or give the illusion of exercising some presidential leadership in getting in the game on debt and deficit reduction. He's going to make a speech tomorrow. We don't know exactly what's going to be in it, but his advisor and his campaign guru back in 08, David Plouffe, he dropped this bomb on all the Sunday talk shows that the president was going to be making a speech on Wednesday, and that the president was going, he's already proposed a budget. Remember this? He's already proposed a budget. You know, it's nibbled around the edges. He said it was $1 trillion in cuts over 10 years, but that's nothing when you're dealing with the multi-trillion dollar deficits and the $14 trillion debt that is bouncing up against the debt ceiling. He already has proposed this, but he's had his thunder stolen by the Republicans and really, really by the Tea Party wing of the Republican Party. And Paul Ryan, with his incredible proposal that really gets serious about saving this country from financial collapse with $6 trillion in cuts over the next 10 years, cuts in entitlements and on and on and on. Now President Obama is suddenly going to get in the game. He apparently is going to talk about, cuts in entitlements, Medicare, Medicaid. But Plouffe says, well, he's not going to do it like the Republicans. He's not going to use a machete. He's going to use a scalpel. Trust me, a scalpel is not going to get it done. The problem, and a good part of it, is his creation with his free spending policies is too big. The surgery performed with a scalpel will not save the patient. You know, sometimes in war, and we're commemorating the start of the Civil War 150 years ago today, sometimes you could only save a patient with an amputation. That's what's going to have to happen here. Programs are going to have to be amputated. Okay? And there's going to have to be some hacking and slashing on the sacred cows of Medicare and Medicaid. And Social Security is going to have to be restructured in a major way. No, I'm not advocating sending grandma out in the cold. But for people 55 and younger, Paul Ryan is right. Things have absolutely got to change. It is not viable. We cannot save this country unless we deal with people from 55 and younger on entitlements. I don't know how serious this president is going to get, but he's going to get in the game, and it is all about ginning up for his reelection campaign in 2012 because he can't deny the numbers. He can't deny what's happening under his regime with the debt and the deficits that are $1.5 trillion a year. He can't deny that we rang up $233 billion in additional debt in February alone, the greatest one-month increase ever. He can't deny the reality that in the 7 days it took to cut the deal with Boehner and Reid and everybody else to avert a government shutdown last Friday night, to cut $39 billion, that in those 7 days, the debt under the Obama regime increased by $54 billion. He's got to get in the game. And so he will. And exactly what he comes up with, I don't know. But one thing the Wall Street Journal is reporting is revenue enhancements are in the mix. Gee, what's a revenue enhancement? Could that be a close cousin to investing in America? Could they both be Obama speak for tax hike? Absolutely. The president is going to once again run it up the flagpole. Tax hikes for those making $250,000 a year or more. Okay? It's an old familiar song. Let me suggest, if President Obama, and I want to see how this sets with you, if President Obama wants to raise taxes on the wealthy because it is only fair that they've made more money and they ought to be able to chip in more than anybody else in a financial crisis like this. Okay, fair enough. How about if I accept that for a moment? What do you say, Mr. Obama, when I remind you that 47% of Americans pay absolutely no federal income tax whatsoever? None. Nada. 47% of U.S. households pay no federal income taxes at all, either because their income tax incomes are too low or because they qualified for enough credits and deductions to eliminate their tax liability. Do you know that it is possible in this country now for a family of four making as much as $50,000 to owe no federal income tax at all as long as they have two kids under 17 and the deductions from them? That's pretty incredible. Do you know, and Mr. Obama, do you know that the top 10% of earners, households making an average of $366,000 a year and more, paid about 73% of the income taxes collected by the federal government? You talk about a lack of fairness. You talk about things out of balance. You know what I want to see? If we can't get the fair tax, and I'd love to see that, and there'll be plenty on that at the Tea Party rally in downtown Orlando Friday afternoon. If we can't get the fair tax, and believe me, the fair tax has so much to recommend it. But they're nowhere near it in Washington. They're in such a mess on so many other things. It's not going to happen short term. How about everybody pays some federal income tax? Why should half the households in this country get all the services provided by the federal government for nothing? Because they don't pay in. Shouldn't everybody have some skin in the game? Even if it's a token payment at all levels, if we're going to have an income tax system, everybody ought to participate in it, Mr. President. If you want revenue enhancement, investing in America, tax hikes, pitch them that way. I mean, hey, it makes sense. Aren't you into redistribution of wealth? Everybody should be more equal. Well, let's get everybody paying some taxes. 407-916-5400. What do you think? 812 on BHL, real-time traffic and weather together on the twos. Hey, I'd be willing to bet that there is a Houlihan's restaurant very near you. There are four great locations in Orlando. Never been to a Houlihan's before? Oh, my goodness. This is Lyndon, my favorite restaurant. Houlihan's is incredible. It's an Orlando tradition. One thing we really love is they make just about everything at Houlihan's from scratch. And few restaurants at any level do that anymore. Food made from scratch, so beautifully done. And the atmosphere is terrific, the service is just exemplary, and they've got a menu that is so diverse for every taste and every price range. And also at Houlihan's, they have a new menu of 30 small plates from just $3. I mean, flatbread, sliders, kebabs, wow, it's just incredible. Houlihan's is where filet mignon meets truck stop fries. How about lunch or dinner today at Houlihan's? Four locations, 192 in Kissimmee, University Boulevard near UCF, iDrive, and East Colonial. I love them all. Online, houlihans.com.
Professional. From 540 WFLA, Orlando's 24-hour weather channel. Chance of a scattered thunderstorm today with a high of 86. From 540 WFLA, Orlando's 24-hour weather channel. Chance of a scattered thunderstorm today with a high of 86. More storms moving through tonight with a low of 62. But back to the sunshine tomorrow with a high of 84. Get the latest news, weather, and traffic anytime at 540WFLA.com.
So you're paying more than ever for gas, so how about making up some ground by saving money on your homeowner's insurance? You can do it through Florida Insurance Specialists, as thousands of my listeners have. Their amazing new technology lets them shop over 30 A-rated companies to get you the best deal, the coverage you need, and your savings. The answer comes back literally in minutes through their website, challengemyrate.com. Look what happened to a Liberty Mutual customer listening to the Bud Man, was paying $3,600 a year for homeowners, got switched in minutes to Security First, saved $1,400 a year. What can you save on homeowners? Go find out right now. Go to challengemyrate.com. Challengemyrate.com. Learn more. Call Florida Insurance Specialists, 407-805-0200. Well, we're going to find out tomorrow the Obama debt-cutting plan. I've talked about his tax hikes that will be proposed for the high-enders. Why shouldn't everybody have to pay at least something and have a stake in this? Half the country gets services for which they pay nothing in federal income taxes. I have such a problem with that. Keith in Winter Garden, good morning.
Hey, good morning, bud.
What do you think?
I am sick and tired of hearing people, and you do this on occasion yourself. I think you're trying to be nice about it. But the reality is people keep trying to give Obama the extra opportunity to prove himself as a conservative or prove himself as just a person who cares about the country. But the reality is every single thing that this man has done to this point has been in his destructive mode to kill the country. And if had not the Republicans won in November, he would have been on the same exact path as he had been before. So why are we assuming that just because the Republicans have gotten, and this is not politics as usual back in the day, this is a man hell-bent on destroying the country. We need to call spade by spade.
Well, now, hang on just a second here, Keith. Let me get you on record. Are you saying that this president wants to destroy America, or just that he has a different vision for America that you and I don't like? Or is he just incompetent in the job? What do you believe?
I think his bit of incompetence is a ruse. I think he's a completely competent individual that is hell-bent on destroying his country. Absolutely.
Why?
Because everything he's done in his past has been, and look at, you know, the old saying is...
No, but why does he want to destroy it? Why does he want to destroy it? Does he fundamentally hate it? He doesn't just have a different vision. He wants to destroy it.
Well, think about it, right?
But no, I don't have to think about it. I want you to tell me, why does he want to destroy it?
I think he wants to destroy this country because he's tired of American exceptionalism. He is more in favor of the European mentality, and quite frankly, he is, if at least, a Muslim sympathizer, or if not at best, a Muslim himself.
I just wanted you to be very direct with what you think. Thank you. Here's Joe in Titusville. Hello, Joe.
How are you doing?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing good. I just think that sharing the taxation, You need to look at companies like GE who didn't pay any taxes.
Taxes in the U.S., which is completely outrageous. You know,
and nobody's saying anything.
Well, because Jeff Immelt is his buddy now, you know, as he tries to schmooze corporate America. It is outrageous. Now, they did pay taxes to other countries where they do business worldwide, but they had no tax burden here in the country, and that is fundamentally wrong.
The other thing I'd like to bring up is, you know, Obama has never discounted or gone against the fair tax. He hasn't supported it, but he hasn't been opposed to it. What would you say if he proposed that in his Wednesday speech?
I would fall off the 50,000-watt front porch. D-O-A. Could not be revived. Do not resuscitate. More calls in 60 seconds, 822 BHL, real-time traffic and weather together now, updated on the twos. Some sunshine this morning, afternoon showers and storms. A few could be severe, so watch out. 87 will be the high, already at 70 degrees here in Orlando. Dave out of Alamon Springs checking in with a Bud Man this morning. Dave, what's on your mind?
It's more of a question, actually. Of your 47% that does not pay into the system, what is the percentage of that that actually uses the system more?
I don't know.
It seems like the people that don't pay anything actually utilize and drain the system by far more than anybody that's actually doing something for it.
Well, I have to tell you, I wouldn't be at all surprised if that's true in significant numbers, but not exclusively true.
Right.
You know, I mean, it is true that they are availing themselves of services that are funded by the federal income tax, and they are contributing nothing for their share of getting national defense, public safety, infrastructure, and education. They're getting a free ride. The heck is that? Where's the fairness in that end of the tax system, Mr. President?
Yeah, I don't believe there is.
I don't believe there is either. Okay, Mark, listening in Orlando. Mark, where are you on this?
But I got to say, you really struck a nerve when you said that family of four that pays $50,000 doesn't pay hardly anything in taxes. And it really gets to me. Where things really started changing for me was about a year ago, but really hit home when I went to a Magic game and my daughter was singing with her classmates at the arena and had to pay $20 each just to be there and were forced to buy a ticket to sing the national anthem there. First time I've been to that arena.
No kidding. Wait a minute. I sang the national anthem in a quartet in the old arena, and we got free seats for the whole game. They charged them $20 a pop to sing the anthem?
They charge.
Oh, what a rip.
What
a ripoff.
It was unbelievable.
I don't know how that ties into Obama and income taxes,
but that's ticking me off. I'm getting to the point. The point is,
Gee, is that
we sit there with a guy like Rich DeVos, build him, making him richer and richer.
He made his money the old-fashioned American way. He created a business in our capitalistic system with the freedoms we have had. He capitalized.
And he put plenty of jobs out there, too. But what I'm talking about is the Magics in particular. He puts in that old stadium could have been renovated.
All right, I got to tell you, I love you, man, but you got me too far off track here. We got to keep the focus on. But charging those kids who are singing the anthem? Oh, shame on you. Man, oh, man. All right, Chris in Kissimmee. Hi, Chris. Good morning.
Hey, good morning, Bud Man. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Great. Hey, you know, I don't think we should pay any more tax because I'm sick of paying taxes. We pay taxes on everything we do. I'm an insurance agent, And people don't realize that when they pass away, it's a 50% death tax unless they have their estate situated properly.
All right.
We're taxed on everything we buy. We're taxed on property taxes. We're taxed on everything. And I don't have any problem paying taxes, but I don't like the way they waste the money. And
right.
I think I'm like a lot of Americans.
I think you are. Taxed enough already. T, as in Tea Party, as in huge Tea Party rally, downtown Orlando, this Friday, 4 to 6, I'm the MC. The Fair Tax folks are co-sponsors of this, the West Orlando Tea Party. And it's going to be awesome. Senator Marco Rubio speaks. Talk show host and presidential contender Herman Cain speaks, and others as well. It's going to be an incredible event, but it won't work without you. Bring your flags, bring your signs, bring your patriotic fervor. The Tea Party movement growing and reignited in downtown Orlando this Friday on tax day, 4 to 6 p.m. Be with us. David in Orlando. Good morning, David.
Good morning, bud.
I'm a little tight on time. I wanted to get you on. What's up?
Thanks, bud. Listen, first of all, I think you're a great patriot and a great American. But I get very frustrated when I hear you talk about pushing the fair tax off to the side. It's very simple, believe it or not.
No, I'm not pushing it off on side. I'm a realist. In Congress, it's not on the radar screen right now. They're in such big trouble in so many other areas. That's all I'm saying. You're misunderstanding me.
Well, okay, then. I think Congress should, if they seriously want to do something to change America, and, you know, after you read the book, The Fair Tax, and you understand it, and if they really want to change America and bring it back to the greatness, I think this, they should get rid of the 16th Amendment, on top of that, the 17th Amendment, implement the Fair Tax, and let this country work like it did when it began.
I do not disagree. Thank you. Coming up on BHL. They got a couple of extra space shuttles. They're going to be decommissioned as the program comes to an end, sadly. Where should they go? We're going to be told today. I have a fantastic idea. See what you think of it as we continue. 829.
Choice. Just put
Well, Michelle's been telling you on and off this morning in the news that today is decision day for what happens to the remaining space shuttles when they shut the program down. One of the three remaining orbiters is going to the Smithsonian in Washington to the Air and Space Museum, and that's exactly where it should be. I have no issue with that at all. The announcement is going to be made today on this by NASA Administrator and former astronaut Charlie Bolden, and he's going to be making the announcement out at the Kennedy Space Center. You have to believe that one of the two remaining shuttles is going to wind up on permanent display at KSC, and that absolutely should happen. I will be shocked if it doesn't happen. The wild card here is, and I think I have a fantastic idea. Unfortunately, I had it too late, and I don't know that anybody in power would listen to me on this anyway, but they should. Everybody's wondering, where's it going to wind up? They think it's going to be places that are the biggest magnets for tourists, and that the candidates are Los Angeles, New York City, Seattle, and Dayton, Ohio. Why Dayton, Ohio? What is that all about? You know, why don't they put it in Glen Rock, New Jersey, where I grew up?
If anybody in Dayton's listening,
oh, I have no idea why. What is the deal on that? It must be some congressional. Maybe it's Boehner's district or something.
You ever been to Dayton?
No.
It's terrific.
Well, I'm not.
And I, for one, am offended that you would say that. it's terrific there.
I'm not anti-Dayton.
There's actually a spot in Dayton.
As a matter of fact, in my time, I did a lot of Dayton.
Oh, wow.
And long ago. Yeah. At any rate, come on now. Listen to this. And here's where I got the idea, Jeff. What we need to do is we need to have the final orbiter be a mobile museum. It needs to be on a big flatbed truck. And it needs to be carted around to communities and schools all over this country. And where I got this idea is this. Do you know the half-size Vietnam Memorial Wall that some veterans organizations make available to travel around, and they set it up with all 58,000 names on the wall. It's just an extraordinary thing. They've had it here in Orlando, and it moves around the country. And this is what gave me the inspiration on this. Now, here I need an engineering consultation, because the shuttle is 122 feet long. I believe that could be accommodated on a nice, long trailer, okay? But the wingspan is about 75 feet. Thanks for looking that up and confirming it. That would not work. It's too wide. You couldn't take it down the highway.
Right. Logistically speaking, that wouldn't work.
But here's the engineering thing we need to do. On aircraft carriers, they use planes with folding wings. The wings fold up to save space. You get more planes on there, okay? Couldn't they hinge those wings and put them up, and then when they display it, bring them down? Could that be done with the space shuttle? I have to believe, my goodness, anything is possible with the engineering talent that we have. And then take this all around. What a great inspiration it would be. It would be seen by far more people over time than could ever see it in any museum in any major city. This is what ought to be done. It would be a rolling ambassador for NASA and for the return to a manned space program with Made in America on it. Wouldn't that be incredible? Small towns, large towns, schools, all across this country. Put that shuttle on a flatbed, fold up the wings, fold them down when it displays, and let America see this great treasure. Oh, no. Jeff, you did it to me. I've got the Dayton folks coming out of the woodwork, loaded for bear, and taking aim at the Bud Man. 407-916-5400. I will take a call on that. But I want to know what you think about my idea for the final space shuttle. One to the Smithsonian, one to Kennedy Space Center, and one permanently on the road for all America to see and appreciate and enjoy. Nancy's in Vieira on Bud Hedinger Live. Welcome from the coast, Nance.
I like your idea, but I want to tell you about Dayton.
Go ahead.
To be honest with you, I don't think there should be one at Dayton. I think your idea is fantastic. But Dayton, the home of flight, Orville and Wilbur Wright. You should see
Oh, that's
mansion.
The reason. See,
you should see Wright State University. Bud, you walk in the student center of Wright State University.
Yeah.
The walls are filled with Orville and Wilbur flying over there, showing Kitty Hawk. And you know those guys have on suits and ties?
You know, I had forgotten that they hailed from Dayton.
How
I always
you?
Think of Kitty Hart.
Listen, the Air Museum at Wright-Patterson Air Force Base is to die for. They have a presidential plane. They've got, and of course, you know, in one of the hangars, too, they've got the little green man.
Huh? Where are you going with this, Nancy?
Hey, no, well, that's the rumor. That's the rumor. You
all
know,
right.
Seriously,
okay.
The museum at Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, people come from all over the world.
Now I get it. Now I get
so
why Dayton is in the
baby
mix.
Doll. I got to get back to bacon.
All right, honey. You're not getting the shuttle, though. That's not happening. That's not. But now I get it. It's, you know, the birthplace of flight. Jeff, that makes some sense to me. So why do you get them stirred up like that? I'm having a nice show here. I'm getting along with the folks, and you light them up on Dayton. You're
what
just
are you talking about? Why am I getting blamed for that?
Because you said
the one who didn't know anything about Dayton. I said Dayton was terrific.
Cindy's in Altamont Springs. Cindy, how are you?
Just great.
So what about my fantastic idea? Put the shuttle on a flatbed. Take it to America. Fold up the wings. Fold them down when you get to some community somewhere.
Well, it's obvious you haven't driven anything bigger than a car because I was a bus driver in San Francisco for a long time. You've got bridges and overpasses to think about.
Well, I don't think it would be that high.
Oh, the 75 feet?
No, well, wait a minute. That's a wingspan. I'm laying it down. I'm laying it down like an airplane, and I'm folding those wings up, but I don't think they're going to go, oh, I see what you're saying. When I fold them up, they might be too high.
When you fold them up, like picking up a high and a, you know. You know, we had a double-decker tour bus.
There's got to be a way.
And there's,
put two hinges on them. Fold them over again. There's got to be a way to do this.
Yeah, even double-decker buses can't go through it.
All right, Cindy. Okay, and you're making me feel bad now. I hate it when I have a great idea and somebody blows it up. Here's Bill in Orlando. Bill, what about it?
Hey, I don't think it'll work on the back of a semi-truck, but, you know, when they land it out in California or New Mexico, they put it on a 747 to fly it back to KSC. Why not just take it to airports and leave it there for a week? And I guess your engineering feat would have to be to build an elevator portable to get up to see it on the back of the 747. I think that would totally work.
Well, where there's a will, there's a way. Unfortunately, I don't think there's any will because there's no awareness of this, and I think I'm definitely a day late on the suggestion. We'll see what happens, Bill. That's an interesting thought. All right, coming up here, Mitt Romney for president. Is he the one? He's formed an exploratory committee. There's a lot I like and have always liked and respected about Mitt Romney. He has one, possibly two, fatal flaws as a candidate in 2012. My take, your calls on Mitt Romney for president. I used to light up the phones with pro-Romney voters who wanted him in 2008. Thought he could have taken out Obama, but it turned out to be McCain. Mitt Romney in 2012, working for you, 407-916-5400. I'll tell you what he had to say, I'll tell you what I have to say, and I'll listen to what you have to say. It's 8:42, checking real-time traffic and weather together on the twos now. hey, thinking about a luxury vehicle, have you thought about the Acura lineup? Boy, I'll tell you what, I don't think I really understood how incredible these machines are, made by Acura and sold by Fountain Acura, until I developed this relationship with my friends at Fountain Acura, and they're just a wonderful breath of fresh air in the car business. You'll love them all down at Fountain Acura. And the lineup of Acuras is incredible. I want you to think about Acura. I want you to test drive the ones I've been driving for Fountain Acura. The top-of-the-line sedan, the Acura RL, the top-of-the-line 7-passenger MDX from Acura at Fountain Acura. Financing rates on both as low as 0.9% right now. If you're driving an Acura, you know how incredible it is. How about upgrading at Fountain your current Acura model to a similar 2011 Acura model with no money down and a similar monthly payment? It's incredible, but they can make it happen for you at the one and only Fountain Acura. Check them out, South OBT, just south of the Florida Mall. Online, fountainacura.com. You know, the Florida climate just continues to change. I'm thinking yesterday I'm out there roasting and the sunshine is like 92 degrees. Today we're going to have thunderstorms, wind-driven rain. Some of them may be severe. Sure beats up on a paint job, and paint just is not durable enough for the Florida climate. There's got to be a better way. Otherwise, you're just going to be shelling out endlessly every 4 or 5 years thousands of dollars to a painter. And what kind of guarantee do you get from a painter? None that I can recall ever getting. This is why you don't ever paint again. What you do is you go for the great alternative to paint, that is Colorcrete, and you get a 25-year guarantee. Colorcrete is made right here in Orlando by a family-owned business, Colorcrete of Central Florida, serving us for a full half century. Jim Dawson and his crew, salt of the earth, as good as it gets, wonderful folks to know and to do business with, and boy, do they have a product that'll knock your eyes out. It is Colorcrete, a 25-year guarantee, unlike with paint, with Colorcrete, a protective barrier against wind-driven rain that we get so often. It'll prevent mildew that we all get on our paint jobs, and it puts a stop to peeling chalking and cracking. How much better can it get? A great ColorCrete price now reduced 10% for you with a free pressure cleaning of your driveway and sidewalks. The great alternative to paint. It is ColorCrete. Don't paint, ColorCrete. Starts with a free estimate. Call them. Tell them the Bud Man says, hey, will you? You're going to love this. ColorCrete, 407-851-3442. Get that free estimate today, 407-851-3442. Online, ColorCreteUSA.com. Mitt Romney has the Midas touch in business. He understands economics and finance. I mean, we desperately need that more than we needed it in 2008. He's a man, I think, of exemplary character. He's a classy guy. He also happens to look like you sent to Central Casting and said, please give me a president to star in a movie. Okay? So there's a lot to like about Mitt Romney. He is in the race. Tim Pawlenty is the first Republican officially in, and Mitt Romney yesterday announced that he is forming an exploratory committee. And in part, he said President Obama has been a failure.
President Obama's policies have failed. He and virtually all the people around him have never worked in the real economy. They just don't know how jobs are created in the private sector. That's where I spent my entire career.
And Mitt Romney went on and said some things that we've heard him say before. There's a lot I like about Mitt Romney, but I got to tell you, he's another one of these candidates on the Republican side that I think has fatal flaws. And it really concerns me. And I think maybe the fatal flaw for Mitt Romney now is not something that was a big issue in 2008, the fact that he's a Mormon. And a lot of conservative Christians have a real problem with that. I don't hear that as much anymore. I don't get the emails on that from you folks. I don't get the calls on that issue like I did. The issue is Obamacare. Obamacare is the centerpiece of the Obama administration, the giant leap towards socialized medicine. We want to undo Obamacare. This is a huge campaign issue. Here we have Mitt Romney. He came up with MassCare and signed off on it, which is Obamacare-like for the state of Massachusetts. And it's done some good things, but it's on the verge of bankrupting his own home state. And I think that's going to be an albatross for him. And I think it's going to kill him in the presidential primaries on the Republican side. I don't think you can run Mitt Romney because of the health care issue. And MassCare as Obamacare light, because it will take Obamacare off the table as an issue to run against President Obama on. When you got a guy who essentially has stood for the same set of principles of government control of health care. I don't think Mitt Romney can survive it. 407-916-5400. Mitt Romney for president. Would he get your vote? Yes, tell me why. No, tell me why. Phones in 60 seconds. Real-time traffic and weather together on the twos. Final check right now at 8:52. All right, Courtney, thank you. Some sunshine this morning. Catch it early. Chance of showers and storms. A few could be severe this afternoon is when you want to watch for that. 87 degrees for the high, 71 already here in Orlando. Jeanette, you're on the air with a Bud Man from Orlando talking Mitt Romney for president, Jeanette.
Good morning, Bud.
Hi.
I love you, but I have to strongly disagree with you this morning. I just think you are completely off base on this one.
Go for it.
I am a Hispanic woman. I come from a long line of devout Democrats. Most of my friends are liberals. And I am a conservative Christian. Yet when you mention Mitt Romney, they are all in. This notion that there is a 40-40-20 split, that 40% of the vote is going Democrat, 40 is going Republican, and that they're only going for the 20% independent voters, this is complete nonsense. There are candidates that break that 40% by stealing votes from the other side, and they respect the truth is that the Hispanic community and a lot of liberals that I know, they respect the success of Mitt Romney. They see him as being more centrist, and you know, just like Donald Trump, they seem to forget all of their conservative principles. They throw that right out the window because they're sort of blinded by his success. We need to win. We have the pressure from within to get them to carry out our wishes. If we remain vigilant, we can't go back to sleep.
All right, now hang on here, Jeanette. Hang on here. I'm not so sure we have too much of a disagreement, but I want you to tell me whether you understand my point about his health care program in Massachusetts, Obamacare Lite.
Sure. Better to debate this issue with him than someone who tried what he did, and he could lay out exactly what went wrong. This was basically a whole situation run amok.
But he isn't apologizing for it. If a year ago he had said, this was a disaster, I gave it a shot, this is a road we never need
sure.
to go down, but he's not doing that. He is defending. Hang on a sec, darling. He is hanging on. He is defending this here. He is defending mass care, Obamacare Lite, if you will, in Massachusetts, saying this is a state's rights issue. And, you know, one state after another should try things they think are going to work. And some things work, some things didn't. If he had said this was a flat-out disaster a year ago, he could have separated himself from it. I don't believe he can possibly win the Republican nomination. There'll be too much pushback against the guy who was ahead of Obama on government-managed health care.
But that is his ace in the hole.
Ah.
He can basically say, I tried this. It did not work.
I think it's a three of clubs. I don't think it's an ace.
He's not apologizing, but he cannot come out and openly apologize, because if he does that, then he loses the support that he could steal from the other 40%.
Okay, now what about the Mormon issue?
I think that may have been an issue in the past. I mean, I, as a conservative Christian, I did support him at first, and I did have my mother-in-law, who is also a devout Christian, and would not vote for him. And I blame her and others like her for us getting John McCain, which I knew he could not win.
All right. Thank you. Terrific call. Appreciate that. Want to move on to get some other folks on. And Jason, you're next from Oviedo. Good morning, Jason.
Good morning, Bud. Hey, I say that you're hitting this right on the head. You know, when I look at Romney, I see his business career. I see, you know, his charm. I see his character. I said, you know, this is a very good man.
Oh, yeah.
A successful businessman. But how is he going to see Obama when Obama has already said, hey, my health care bill is very similar to one that Mitt Romney put in when he was governor of Massachusetts?
Yeah, and Obama purposely did that to try to give him the kiss of death in the Republican race. There's no doubt about that, Jason. Obama knew exactly what he was doing. And trust me, that's going to be a big, big hurdle for Mitt Romney, and maybe insurmountable. New Smyrna Beach, home of Vicky. Welcome aboard, Vicky. Good morning.
How do you do? I just don't understand one thing. I'm a great Herman Cain supporter, and I can't believe you saying all these things about Mitt Romney when Herman Cain is going to be at the rally on Friday.
Herman Cain's going to be on the show. Jeff, we got him booked here. He's going to be interviewed by the Budman on Thursday. Is that right?
Correct.
Yeah. I love Herman Cain, the voice of Herman Cain, and I've talked about him on the program, Vicky, and I like this man. We just don't happen to be talking about him right now.
Okay, well, I just wanted to say that he makes, when Herman Cain talks, he makes Mitt Romney look like a Democrat.
Well, you know, you're right. Nobody's more rock solid than Herman.